As we learn of a bombshell new letter about his accuser, one that seems to poke holes in some key parts of her testimony. Texas Republican Senator John Cornyn sits on the Senate Judiciary Committee. He is also the Senate Majority Whip. He joins us now. Senator, thank you for your time this morning. You are obviously playing a crucial role in all of this. First, can you just give us an update on the situation as you see it at this moment?
Well, we're expecting the FBI supplemental background investigation report at any time now, and this is something that a number of senators wanted to see. So we've exhausted the attempts to try to corroborate or not what Dr. Ford had said and what others have said. So far, we've got no corroboration. Senator McConnell said once senators have had a chance to read the report, then we'll be voting on the confirmation this week. Unfortunately, this confirmation process has turned into something very different from what we'd ordinarily expect, and I think it's really more like a three-ring circus, and I say that with all apologies to circuses. But we need to vote on this nomination, and we need to get it done this week.
You have spent your days leading up to this, a meeting with undecided senators. How is that going?
Well, we're having good conversations with all of my colleagues. Unfortunately, about half of the Senate has already made up its mind. They did so before the nominee was even named. And Senator Schumer, for example, the Democratic leader, said he would do everything in his power to stop the confirmation of Brett Kavanaugh. So this isn't exactly what I would call a fair process where people have an open mind. Unfortunately, rather than a search for the truth, this has become a search and destroy mission. And now my Democratic colleagues are questioning Judge Kavanaugh's temperament because while they assassinated his character, while they accused him of crimes and things that were really just unimaginable, he sought to defend himself at his second hearing, and now they're criticizing him for defending himself. I just think this needs to end, and that's why we need to vote.
Similar sentiments echoed by your colleague in the Senate, John Kennedy, a few moments ago on this program. Listen.
Some of my colleagues on the Democratic side are in good faith. Some, I'm convinced, I could be convinced, I'm rapidly being convinced, don't have a soul. They don't care who gets destroyed, Dr. Ford, her confidentiality, her family. They don't care if Brett Kavanaugh gets destroyed, his reputation. It's just, their whole mantra is just win, baby. Just win, do whatever it takes.
Leader McConnell says Democrats will not be satisfied unless they bring down Judge Kavanaugh's nomination. So while we await the outcome of this FBI investigation, will Democrats accept that?
Well, they won't accept the FBI investigation because they continue to add additional things, throw them against the wall, hoping they will stick. And again, that's why we do need to vote. But Senator Kennedy is exactly right. This has turned into a destruction of a good man and his reputation and harm to his family. And just think about this. If this is the precedent for future nominations, who will want to serve? Who will go through this kind of process knowing that they risk destruction of everything they've worked for their professional lives if they were to do it? So this is a test for the Senate. This is a test for the country. This is a test for our constitutional system that's based on a fundamentally fair process. So there's a lot at stake.
Senator Cornyn, you suggested just a few moments ago that at any moment we could see get to see that FBI report. If that's the case, and if that comes out today, how soon could a vote happen?
Well, I know that Senator McConnell said we need to vote this week, which means that he would have to file a cloture petition. There would be an intervening day. In other words, there'd be a couple of days before there would be the first vote. So there'll be plenty of time for senators to get briefed on the FBI background investigation, should they choose to do so, before we vote. I think that's what we owe the senators. They need to get the report from the FBI before they vote, and I believe that will happen.
Are you as confident as Leader McConnell that that vote could happen this week?
I am.
Senator Cornyn, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.
Bill?
Big developments on that. Back to what we heard from Mike Pompeo.